I think a lot of students are afraid of math. You hear frequently, I'm not a math person. And a lot of times it's they are good at math. They just don't realize it. And if I can help bring that self-realization, that self-discovery, make math less frightening, less scary for kids, that maybe it'll spark some type of interest in not just the topic, but in other type of STEM or STEAM career fields. Gamification can look like a lot of different things. There's game-based learning, where you're playing games and using that to have students learn or practice concepts in the classroom. And then there's also something called gamification, which is taking game-based attributes and applying them to normal things. The biggest change that I've made to gamify my classroom is simply by the vocabulary I use. I've decided to reword some of the terms that I use in class. So instead of calling it a lesson, I call it a quest. Instead of it being a chapter, I call it a level. And instead of a unit, I call it a world. And I theme them. And then extended learning activities, I call them side quests, and they're for extra credit. The biggest thing, and it also reduces test anxiety, quizzes in my classroom are called boss battles. And yes, they can do a rematch. So this kind of changes the mindset of the students. So it's just doing ordinary learning and practices becomes more like a game to them, even though they're not actually playing a game. And also I redecorate my classroom. I'll show you really quick here. That right now our theme is Alice in Wonderland. And so I've just made some simple decorations around the room to be themed Alice in Wonderland. So this is our game board where students can track their progress. So students can grab whatever they need, the materials they need, they're tracking their progress. It's kind of ordinary, but I set it up to be like a game board, like moving their token across the game board. So simple adjustments like this can make a big difference. My administrators, they love the ideas. They love that it's different. They love that it's student-centered, and it's just fun. It's fun for the kids. And of course they like the data that goes along with it. In past years, I've had like that traditional bell curve, you know, class average is a C. Now my class averages are a B. Start small, really simple, really basic. You can always add just a little bit more, you know, when you're ready to add another element. I started gamification probably about 7 or 8 years ago, and it was simply tracking student progress. I themed my classroom with Monopoly, and I called it Mathopoly. And it simply started as I gave them a sheet of paper, and on this paper were boxes that kind of looked like those property spaces. And I had them write, and each property represented a quiz that they took. And I had them write down their quiz scores on it. And I had stamps made at Staples, you know, green stampers with houses and red ones with hotels. And I would just walk around. I had a rubric of how many houses or if they'd get a hotel based on their score. And I'd walk around stamping their papers, and they loved it. And they're like, ooh, I want more houses. How do we get more houses? Okay, you want to retake that quiz for a higher score, and then I'll give you more houses. And it really started that simple, that basic. And it just kind of like grew from there. And then I, at the end of the year, I said, oh, maybe I'll turn this into a review game for their final exam. And it was a gradual build from where I started to what I'm doing today. So, you know, you don't have to think that it's overwhelming. Ideas can come from anywhere and everywhere. And just add a little bit at a time as you're comfortable.